Have you started slowing down? A performance plateau affects every runner at some point in their running career. You can't just keep progressing and improving and getting better week after week and month after month as a runner. It doesn't really work like that. And sometimes our physiology prevents us from getting better because we're doing the same training over and over again. So if you're someone who maybe is slowing down, maybe isn't improving, or you're just not improving as much as you'd like, there are certain things you can do in your training to force more adaptations. Because once we do something different, once we start introducing a little bit more stress to our training, then we will give ourselves those opportunities to get better, adapt to those new stresses, and ultimately become faster runners. So what I'm gonna do in this video is talk about 13 of my favorite strategies for getting better. These are training strategies, mindset strategies, and new ways of thinking about running. So if you are in a slump, if you've hit a plateau, this video is for you. And if you know a runner who's in a slump as well, go ahead and forward them this video because I want every runner to have the ideas and the tools to get better if that's their goal. Tip number one is to run higher mileage. Now, one of the things that I do as a running coach for hire is that I write a lot of custom training plans. Part of that process is having the athlete fill out a questionnaire. And I've written more than 2,000 custom plans since I started doing these back in 2011. And through this process, I've learned so many things about how runners think about their training, and most runners aren't running enough mileage to truly glimpse their potential. I'd say the average runner is running about 20 to 30 miles a week. Some runners are running 30 to 40. A few runners are running 40 to 50, and there are very few adult recreational runners who venture into the 50 plus mile per week territory. And if you are having a situation where you're not getting any better and your mileage is lower than 40 to 50 miles a week, now's the time to run higher mileage. Give yourself that stress of more endurance and you'll become a better runner. Strategy number two is to move away from the race distance that you've been training for very consistently and try a new race distance. You know, I talk to a lot of runners whose ultimate goal is to become a faster marathoner. They want to break the 5-hour mark, the 4-hour mark, qualify for Boston, maybe even break the 3-hour mark. And they do this by training to run 2 to 3 marathons a year. But if you're always training for a marathon, you're always doing marathon training. You're not giving your body stresses that are going to prompt you to get really fast. You're doing a lot of aerobic endurance work, which is great, but switching things up, giving yourself a new training stimulus, say if you're training for a 5K or even a shorter event, is going to prompt you to get faster. And if you get faster, if you increase your speed ceiling, you have more available speed to you, you layer on a little bit of endurance work and your marathon is definitely going to improve. Tip number three to continue improving is to run fast regularly by doing either strides or hill sprints. Strides are about 100 meter accelerations. There's a link under this video to see a demonstration. And hill sprints are about 8 to 10 second maximum intensity sprints up a steep hill. Now the key here is to simply do these consistently, about twice a week, indefinitely. These are fundamental aspects of training, similar to a long run, so that we have to do them regularly. And if you're someone who never practices running fast, recognize that speed is a skill. And to develop that skill, we have to practice it often. So start doing about 4 strides after your easy runs, once, twice, or maybe 3 times a week. And over a couple weeks and months, you're gonna find that faster running feels easier, you feel more efficient and economical, and you'll become faster in your races too. Okay, tip number four, get a coach. If you're someone who has the means to hire a coach, whether that's for just a couple months, maybe it's just for a custom training plan, otherwise, get a second set of eyes on your running. A coach can provide you that opportunity to get outside expertise. Someone who can look at what you're doing and point out the areas where you should keep doing what you're doing, you should add new things, and maybe there are some things that you should stop doing. a coach is a valuable resource. And when we get coaches in other aspects of our lives, whether that's a nutritionist, whether that's getting someone to do work around the house for you that you're not qualified to do, I know I'm qualified for virtually nothing around my house, we always hire outside experts. And we can do the same for our running, and it's probably going to give you a lot of insights into how to train personally for you to help yourself get better. Tip number five is, let's add some aerobic cross training to our schedule throughout the week. If you're someone who can't run higher mileage because you're very injury prone, then we can effectively add equivalent mileage to your training plan by doing some cross training like pool running, cycling, or even the elliptical. This is similar to adding just another easy run or some extra miles at an easy effort to your training plan. So if you're someone who can't run high mileage because you simply can't, you get hurt, or you know it leaves you too sore, then cross training is a really nice way to give yourself that stimulus for endurance adaptations without the unnecessary injury risk. Tip number six, that's right, is start lifting weights. If you're not someone who's regularly doing strength training, you should know that strength training is integral to you not only staying healthy, but also reaching your potential. Strength training helps you improve your running economy. It allows you to produce more force, which allows you to run faster, and it reduces your injury risk. Strength training is so important that I don't even call it cross training. It's just part of the training that runners have to do to reach their potential. Tip number seven is to be more consistent with your long runs, and particularly with longer long runs. If your long run is regularly in the double digits, at least 10 miles, you are putting yourself in a position where you are gaining more endurance than the average runner, and you're setting yourself up so that if you want to transition to ultra marathon training, half marathon training, marathon training, any of the longer races, you are primed to do exactly that. And regular completion of a long run, most weeks, is one of the best things that you can do to continue developing your aerobic metabolism. Tip number eight is, let's reduce your risk by actually training appropriately. Now, your risk for injury is affected by a lot of different things. Your running form, your history with injuries, but the number one contributor to injuries is poor training. So find a good training plan that has logical, coherent progressions of mileage, of workouts, and long runs. And also a plan that is appropriate for you, not just your fitness level, but the race that you're training for and where you are in the training cycle. You're obviously going to do very different training if you're 3 weeks out from your race as opposed to 15 weeks out from your race. A good plan will take all that into consideration, lay it out for you so you don't have to do any of that work. And this is the number one injury prevention tool that you have. Simply train well. All right, tip number nine is level up your lifestyle so that you are creating the environment in which you can actually get faster. So what I mean by that is three things. Number one, sleep. If you're not good at getting a good night's sleep, then let's focus on sleeping more, and let's also focus on your sleep quality. You can get blackout shades, you can wear a mask, you can use a sound machine, or there's lots of fancy things you can do to help yourself get better sleep. But that's number one. Sleep really is your number one recovery tool. So once you've nailed down your sleep, now let's level up your diet. Let's improve our nutrition so that we're giving our body the fuel it needs to run well and to recover well. And then finally, there's the stress levels in your life. It's really hard to take on a lot of running stress. Maybe you're training for a marathon or a PR in another distance. That is a stressful thing to do. And if you're taking on a lot of stress at home, taking on a lot of stress at work with projects, you're breaking up with your boyfriend, these are terrible times for you to layer on even more stress with difficult training. So just be aware of your stress levels, do everything you can to reduce them, and try to plan your training around some of those big stressful life events so that you're not trying to do everything all at once, which ultimately will mean you're not gonna do anything really well. All right, we're up to tip number 10, which is to run more short races. I think I've talked to a lot of runners who don't race very often, or even if they choose a 5K or a 10K, They only have one, maybe two in their training season. But these short races don't take a lot out of you. You could effectively run a 5K every weekend for 6 weeks. And by running these short races more frequently, you're number one, giving yourself more opportunity to improve. And number two, you will essentially be racing yourself into a higher level of fitness. Racing is a skill. It takes time to master. It takes a lot of failures to master. So you have to put yourself out there. You have to take risks and run a variety of different race strategies so that you can find out what works for you, what doesn't work for you. And only by putting yourself into those risky situations. Maybe that's going out really fast. Maybe that's starting your kick a full mile out from the finish line rather than a half mile out. Whatever the strategy might be, this will teach you more about yourself. You will become a more skilled racer and you'll get faster in the process. Tip number 11 is to try a new race. And I don't mean a new race distance, I mean a completely new type of event. Maybe if you've only done road races, let's do an obstacle course race. Let's try an ultra marathon. Let's do a trail race or maybe a mountain event. There are so many options out there. You can even get a little bit outside your running comfort zone and do a duathlon or maybe even a triathlon. I know that I have participated in all of these different events and they're just great because you get to learn more about yourself as a runner. You get to do different types of training and it keeps both your training fresh and it keeps your psychology fresh because you're always motivated to train because you're going after different types of goals. So if you're in a bit of a rut, focus on something that you've never done before, and I think you're not only gonna get a lot out of it physically, but you're just gonna have more fun. Tip number 12 is to invest in your knowledge of the sport. Obviously, if you know more about running, you're gonna make better training decisions. So good on you for watching these YouTube videos so that you can learn more about running. You can also buy books, take courses. You could go get your own coaching certification. Maybe you join a club and link up with some runners who are much better than you so that you can learn from them. There's a lot of opportunities that are available, but always remember that knowledge is a competitive advantage. The more you know, the better decisions you'll make, the less you will get injured, and the better training you'll have so that you can become a better runner. And finally, tip number 13, I can't do anymore. This is getting too hard. Tip number 13 is to surround yourself with support. Now, a lot of that is other runners. Surrounding yourself with other runners who you can talk to about your challenges, you can share stories with, you can get advice from. Maybe that is like a running club that has a coach. So you can ask more technical training questions to the coach. Now, this is so important because I think a lot of us tend to be lone wolves. We run alone, we don't like to ask for help, but ultimately, becoming a good runner is a very difficult prospect. You have to put yourself in highly stressful situations. You have to be very consistent with hard work for a very long time. And to do that, it makes it a lot easier if you are around people who are like-minded, who will encourage you and support you and cheer you on, but also will be a shoulder to lean on, virtually, in this time. If you have a bad race or a bad workout or you get hurt, don't discount the value of support from your peers. This is so critical, and I know that looking back on my career, I never would have accomplished anything I did if I wasn't on a team. If I wasn't surrounded by guys that I considered my friends, pushing me forward, setting a good example for me, doing really well themselves, which motivated me to keep up with them. There's so many ways that we can succumb to this positive peer pressure of being in a group. Because when the group is working really hard towards a good goal, that brings everyone with them. So if you are someone who trains alone, if you're not involved in the running community whatsoever, whether that's in person or even an online group, an online team, getting a coach, some aspect of being involved in the running community, it will increase your motivation. It will give you new ideas for your training. You'll have more fun. And those things all lead to faster runners. Now, I have just given you a ton of ideas for improvement. Should you try all of these at once? No, of course not. You'd probably get hurt. It's just too much to juggle all at once. So I want you to think about these things and recognize which ones you might need to work on a little bit more, or maybe which ideas that you just haven't implemented at all. Those are the good places to start. And if you want more support, if maybe you want to talk to me one-on-one or join a live coaching call with a bunch of other runners to chat about different issues, then we are now opening our Team Strength Running coaching program. This is a group coaching program. It's affordable for everyone. And what we do here is give you the support, the ideas, the tools, and the coaching to accomplish your goals. We're now open at strengthrunning.com/join, and I hope you'll join us because next week I'm doing a bonus live event for members of the team. Check out that link, see if the team is right for you, and I hope to see you on the inside.